In the past, Motherson has come out and said that this does not impact their business whatsoever. But we will try and reach out to the company and see sort of if there's anything fresh. Actually, let's take up this talk in this company with our next guest. Mayuresh Joshi is joining in. Good afternoon, Mayuresh. Your thoughts on Motherson?
So, Surbhi, I think what developments have happened, and in the past as well, you're right, I think the management did put the statement that that does not affect the financials of the company. But largely, again, I think one needs to look at the intensity of what has actually transpired at this point of time. So let's understand the facts of this case a little bit further before we take a call on this talk.
Fair enough. Mayuresh, hi, good afternoon. Thoughts on Dr. Reddy's? 2% up, but that's half the statement. From the lowest, quite a bit of recovery.
Oh, absolutely, Anuj. And again, I think the kind of developments for the pharma space, I think, have been phenomenal over the past few weeks. So I think over the past few months, pricing pressures, what probably happened in terms of FDA concerns, were plaguing the stock and the prices as well. But I think the developments that have probably happened with what has taken place with the AIR for Sun, what you've probably seen in terms of the at-risk launch that Dr. Reddy's has done, and again, I think the developments related to this launch, I think the company is possessing a very strong specialized pipeline, are going to benefit FY20 onwards. So from a near-term FY19 perspective, I think it's well captured in terms of how the price earnings multiples are. But the specialty pipeline is something which is going to differentiate these pharma majors from the rest of the pack. So I'll have a stock specific view at this point of time. For Dr. Reddy's, it's a neutral view that we're probably maintaining. What we're probably liking from the larger universe might be something like Anitka Lab, or hold on to stocks like a Lupin or a Sun Pharma.
May I raise a call on Bata at current prices?
So valuation should be again on the higher side. If even if one assumes an EPS around 27-28, trades 30 times FY20 numbers. But the numbers have been phenomenal. So if you look at the EBITDA margins for FY18, they closed it at 13.6%. The rentals have come down to around 13.8%. They're capping that off. The cash on their books is 588 odd crores. The gross margins are at 54.5%. What you're talking in terms of the new ads that you might have seen on television, the premiumization aspect, the women's footwear aspect, the bubble gummer, which is the children's footwear, is all picking up steam. Anywhere between 1,000 rupees, lower GST rates, margins expected to remain extremely stable. So expecting a strong growth in terms of 15% revenue, 20% bottom line. But again, I think valuations is something that one can probably comprehend the stock at this point of time. But anybody holding on to stock like Bata should probably hold on in terms of the sheer balance sheet dynamics.
You go, you have one stock pick for us. You seem to like Aditya Birla Capital. What are the triggers here?
So, Surbhi, I think the entire logic here is the financialization of savings. And if you look at their subdivisions, the NBFC arm for FY18 has done exceedingly well. You've seen a 25% growth in AUM to 34,700 crores, with GNPAs and NPAs maintained at 0.9, 0.6, NIMs maintained at 4.4. The AUM portion, the assets under management, have increased 25% as well. So to that bit, again, I think the kind of improvement specifically through equity SIPs, which have grown to 950-odd crores from 500 crores, is a testimony of that fact. The insurance part of the business has reported positive VNBs at 4.3% compared to 5.5% negative VNBs in the year gone by. And specifically in terms of the housing finance business, it's doubled to 8,200 crores with NIMs of 3%. So the entire logic in terms of their profits actually growing 47% over the next couple of years. And on an SOTP basis, if you value the NBFC arm at 3 times adjusted book, the housing finance arm at 3.2 times adjusted book, if you're looking at the equity AUM portion at 7 times, at 7% of AUM, and again, I think the life insurance part at 3 times embedded value, there is significant value, in my opinion, even from the current levels at Aditya Birla Capital trade. So on declines in a staggered way is how long-term investors can look at this.
Okay. All right, gentlemen. We'll wind it up on that note then. Thanks very much for taking us through Monday trade. An absolutely flat end to what was